and this is our sixth standard, and I'm going to teach you history music. So now I'm going to share the PPT screen.
Yes, I've learned about the three dynasties, one Chalukya and Chola dynasties, second one Savana dynasty, and third one is Vakataka dynasty. Now I'm going to ask you some on knowledge. So first question is, who was founder of Satavahana dynasty? I repeat, who was the founder of Satavahana dynasty? Option first is Ashoka and second is Simuk. Yes,
tell me the answer.
Yes, students, anyone? Very good, Simuk. Simuk was the founder of Satavahana dynasty. Very good. Now the second question. What was the emblem for Pandya dynasty? What was the emblem for Pandya dynasty? Option first is fish and option second is tiger.
Tiger.
Tiger. Think of again.
What fish?
Fish is the symbol for Pandya dynasty. Then tell me, tiger was the symbol for which dynasty? Yes.
May I bolu?
Yes, you may.
Gautami Satkarani.
Tell me the first answer of the second question, beta. Tiger, tiger emblem for which dynasty? Chair or Chola? Tiger emblem for the Chola dynasty. Okay. Now the third question.
Pandya dynasty.
Okay. Now the third question. Which Satavahana ruler known as Tri Samudra Toya Pit Vahan? First option is Harishen and second one is Gautami Putra Satkarni. Yes, tell me the answer. The ruler who known as Tri Samudra Toya Pit
Vahan. Ma'am, I bolu Gautami Putra Satkarni.
Very good.
Gautami Putra Satkarni.
Very good. Known as Tri Samudra Toya Pit Vahan. Very good. Now the last question. Who wrote Setu Bandha? Yes. First option is Kalidas and second one is Pravarsen 2.
Kalidas.
Kalidas. Think again, beta. Setu Bandha is there. Literature. Yesterday I taught you two literature. First one Setu Bandha and second one? Yes, think again.
Second reversion 2.
Yes, Pravarsen
2.
Okay, Pravarsen 2 is the correct answer. Very good. So yesterday we have learned about all these. Now tell me, the Kalidas wrote Meghdoot, not the Setu Bandha. Setu Bandha composed by which king? The king Pravarsen II. And the Kalidas composed the Meghdoot. Okay. Now I'm going to teach you the next part of our lesson. What is the name of our lesson? Ancient Kingdoms of the South, Part 2. So here we are going to learn three dynasties. First one is the Chalukya dynasty. Second one, the Pallava dynasty. And the third one, the Rashtrakut dynasty. So let's see what is given in the Chalukya dynasty. So Chalukya dynasty is here. The Chalukya dynasty in Karnataka was one powerful. It means that Chalukya dynasty was powerful in Karnataka. Second one is Badami Chalukyas. It means that the earliest Chalukyas with their capital at Badami in Karnataka. Earliest Chalukyas means the ruler of the Chalukyas are ruler of the Chalukyas were rule in Karnataka with their capital at Badami, which also known as the Vatapi. Okay. Third point is Jaya Simha was the first ruler of Chalukyas. It also called as the founder of the who was the founder of Chalukyas. So Jaya Simha. The next point is Pulkeshin first reign 543 AD to 566 AD. Pulkeshin first was the king who was rule in that Chalukya dynasty from 553 AD. AD means anno domino to 566 AD. He ruled in the Chalukya dynasty in the 6th century CE. It means that Pulkeshin first, the king who was rule in the Chalukya dynasty in the 6th century CE, common era. Second point, he founded the empire with his capital as Vatapi. Pulkeshin first was founded the whole empire with his capital of Vatapi. If anyone ask you that what is the capital of Chalukya dynasty, then your answer should be Vatapi. Okay. Now second one is the Pulkeshin second. Here the another king name is given, Pulkeshin second. The reign from 609 AD to 642 AD. The greatest of the Chalukya kings. The Pulkeshin II was known as one of the greatest of the Chalukya kings. Why? Because he extended the Chalukya rule to most parts of the Deccan. He spreaded the Chalukya's territory areas to the most part of the Deccan. That's why he belongs to one of the greatest Chalukya kings. Here the one word is given, Deccan. Deccan means southern part of our India. Pulkeshin II defeated King Harshvardhan's army at Narmada. Here a particular name is given, Harshvardhan's army. Here Harshvardhan is also the king, and there is a fight between the Pulkeshin II and between the Harshvardhan king at Narmada. So now I'm going to show a video of King Harshvardhan. Listen it carefully, then I will explain it. Okay.
King Harshvardhan. The downfall of the Gupta Empire in the middle of the 6th century brought about the breakup of the northern Indian kingdom into many small republics and monarchy states. Prabhakar Vardhan, ruler of Sthanaveswara, Thanesar, in present-day Haryana, was the first ruler of the Vardhana dynasty. He had two sons. The elder son Rajyavardhan, who ascended the throne after his father, and his younger son Rajyavardhan. Rajyavardhan was deceived and murdered in Gauda, at which point the young 16-year-old Harsha swore to take revenge. Harsha waged war against King Gauda and won the battle. Harsha was consequently crowned the new ruler. He first united the kingdoms of and Kannauj, and then went on to bring Bihar, Bengal, and Orissa under his command. Harsha then moved towards the south, only to be stopped by Pulkeshin II of Vatapi. As a result, the
great. मीडिया वॉल्यूम वेट स्टूडेंट्स
किंग हर्षवर्धन The downfall of the Gupta Empire in the middle of the 6th century brought about the breakup of the northern Indian kingdom into many small republics and monarchy states. Prabhakar Vardhan of Sanavisvara Thanesar in present-day Haryana was the first ruler of the Vardhana dynasty. He had two sons, the eldest son Rajyavardhan, who ascended the throne after his father, and his younger son Harshavardhan. Rajyavardhan was deceived and murdered by King Gauda, at which point the young 16-year-old Harsha swore to take revenge. Harsha waged war against King Gauda and won the battle. Harsha was consequently crowned the new ruler. He first united the kingdoms of Thanesar and Kannauj and then went on to bring Bihar, Bengal and Odisha under his command. Harsha then moved towards the south, only to be stopped by Pulakesi II of Vatapi. As a result, the Narmada became the southern limit of Harsha's empire. He was also an author of repute, having penned Sanskrit plays like Nagananda, Ratnavali, and Priyadarsika. Banabhatta, Harsha's court poet, wrote the Harsha Charitam, the first historical poetic work on King Harsha. Harsha's capital city, Kannauj, extended 6 to 8 kilometers along the river Ganges. He also had a systematic tax structure in place. 1/4 of the taxes went towards the administration of his empire. The rest was given away to charities and to further the arts and cultural endeavors in his kingdom. Later on in his life, King Harsha, a Shaivite by birth, became a follower of Buddhism. Under him, all religions and schools of thought, like Jainism and Buddhism, enjoyed freedom of expression. Harsha ruled ably for 41 years. With King Harsha's passing, the idea of a single kingdom ruling northern India disintegrated.
So, all students, I hope you listen it carefully. Here in this video, what is given, the life history of Harshvardhan is shown in this video. So, here Vardhan's dynasty is given, where Prabhakar Vardhan had two sons. First one is Rajyavardhan and second one is Harshvardhan. The Rajyavardhan, the elder brother, who killed by King Gauda. After his death, what happened? The young 16 years old Harshvardhan, take his responsibility and succeeded the throne of Vardhan's dynasty in 606 AD. After that, what happened? He established his capital at Kannauj also and spreaded Vardhan's dynasty all over the India. While spreading, he also established his capital at Kannauj, and after his achievement, his court poet, that name is Banabhatta. Banabhatta wrote Harshcharitra is a biography of Harshvardhan. So in this way, a short video on the King Harshvardhan. Okay. Now see what is given here. The Badami temples built in Chalukya dynasty. Here I am showing you Badami temples. Okay. After that, also in the Chalukya dynasty, the temple of Pattakkal is also built up. Here is the map of Chalukya dynasty. Everyone can see that green shaded shows the Chalukya dynasty. Near Chalukya dynasty was nearby spreaded in which area? In the Gujarat also, and near to the Maharashtra and the Andhra Pradesh boundaries. Okay.
Here again, extent of the Chalukya dynasty.
In this map, everyone can see the Chalukya dynasty.
Here, kingdoms of Kalachuri and Kadamba had become powerful after the decline of the Vakatakas. Okay. Administration and society. The Chalukyas had great maritime power.
The Chalukya has great maritime. Maritime means we can say navy power or ocean power. It means he has so many soldiers of in the navy.
They also had a well organized army also. Though the Chalukyas kings were Hindus, they were tolerant of Buddhism and Jainism also. Saw great developments in Kannada and Telugu literature. There is lots of development in Kannada and Telugu literature. In the video also, we have seen that Harshavardhan's King Harshavardhan is also give a contribution on the literature.
Now let's see our second dynasty, that is Pallava dynasty. So in the first point, what is given? There is no clarity on the name of the founder of Pallava dynasty. But the rise of Pallavas in the last quarter of the 6th century, it means that there will be no clearly mentioned that who was the founder of the Pallava dynasty. But we have we know that the Pallavas was rise up when in the last quarter of the 6th century. Here the name is given Mahendra Varman first. Is considered to the greatest ruler of the Pallavas. In that dynasty, the famous and greatest ruler known as Mahendra Varman first. Next one is Kanchipuram was the capital of Pallavas. Pallava dynasty has the capital that was Kanchipuram. Next one, Shore Temple at Mahabalipuram and the Kanchi Kailash Santhar Temple at Kanchipuram are famous temples that were constructed during the reign of Pallavas. Here, two temples' name are given, Shore Temple and Kanchi Temple that was built up at the time of Pallava dynasty. The extent of the Pallava dynasty. The Pallava capital was Kanchipuram. We all know. Again, the next, the territories at the height of the powers extended from the northern part of Andhra Pradesh to River Kaveri in the south. Extension of the territories. Extension of their ruling area of Pallava dynasty from where? From the northern part of Andhra Pradesh to River Kaveri in the south. Up to this, the Pallavas are spread over in that dynasty period. Vatapi is also known as Badami, was occupied by the Pallava king Narasimha Varman, who defeated the Chalukyas. The king Narasimha Varman who defeated the Chalukyas. This Pallava's king was defeated the Chalukyas and occupied the Vatapi, is also known as Badami. See, in this picture, everyone can see the Pallava dynasty. Pallava dynasty is nearby to which with two states, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Here, the brief history was given about the Mahendra Varman. Mahendra Varman was a poet and composer also. He introduced rock cut temple architecture, and he also had going on battles with Pulakeshin II of Chalukya dynasty. He had battle with Pulakeshin II of Chalukya dynasty. Mahendra Varman died in the battle with the Chalukyas. In that battle, what happened? Mahendra Varman died. He was an able and efficient ruler. He was one of the greatest ruler of the Pallava dynasty. The Rath temples of Mahabalipuram were sculpted in single rock during his reign. During his ruling period, the famous Ratha temples of Mahabalipuram were sculpted in a single rock only. This is a famous temple, and the specialty of this temple was that whole temple was sculpted in a single rock. See the temple, the Ratha temples, the picture of that temple. Now again I'm going to share the video of Pallava dynasty. Listen it carefully.
The Pallava. The south of India has seen many empires. However, one of the most powerful to exist in that region was the Pallava dynasty. The Pallavas were great conquerors and patrons of art and architecture. They ruled for nearly 500 years. The Pallavas initially conquered the region of Tondai Mandalam in Pallavapuri, right on the coastline. Shortly thereafter, a natural disaster occurred, and the entire area was washed away by the sea. The Pallavas then moved to Kanchipuram, and it was from there that they built their mighty empire, which extended from northern Orissa to Tanjore and Trichy in the far south. Believed to be the first Pallav ruler who ruled in the early part of the 4th century, Skandavarman extended his territories from the Krishna River to Pennar in the south, all the way across to Bellary in the west. After having performed the Ashwamedha and various Vedic rituals, he earned the title of Supreme King of Kings, devoted to Dharma. During the period of 350 to 575 BC, there were over 16 kings who ruled. King Sambhashivu ruled from 560 to 580 BC. He was a strong ruler who defeated the Cholas, Pandyas and Kalabras, which were the original rulers of the southern region. Sambhashivu was a Vaishnavite, a devotee of Lord Vishnu, and his portrait is present in the Adi Varaha temple in Mahabalipuram, Tamil Nadu. Sambhashivu was followed by his son Mahendra Varman, who ruled from 600 to 630 BC. Mahendra Varman was a very learned person, a poet and a skilled musician. His instrument of choice was the veena. He was also a patron of the arts, music and architecture, which flourished during his reign. Stunning cave temples of Mahabalipuram near Chennai were initiated by Mahendra Varman. Narasimha Varman was Mahendra Varman's brave and intelligent son. He had taken control of Badami and continued to rule over it for 13 years. With his powerful navy, he also helped the king of Simhala, Sri Lanka, to get back his lost kingdom. Narasimha Varman, during his reign, completed the beautiful temples of Mahabalipuram. He also built a host of other temples like the Kailasanatha Temple at Kanchipuram and the Shora Temple. He was a great wrestler and had earned the title of Mamalla, which is why Mahabalipuram is also known as Mamallapuram.
So students, in this video, we have learned that Pallavas were most powerful in which area? In the southern part of our India. Again, the Pallavas rule nearby 500 years on that period. In this video, we have seen that Skanda Varman, who ruled at the beginning of the 4th century AD, and he was the first ruler of the Pallava dynasty. He performed some Ashwamedha and other Vedic sacrifices. So he was known as the supreme king of devotee dharma. Again, what happened? The extension means the ruling territories of the Pallava dynasty was from Krishna River to Pennar. The Pallavas ruler territories was from Krishna River to Pennar.
So in this video we have seen about the Pallava dynasty. Now let's see our third important dynasty, that is Rashtrakut dynasty.
Here the first point is Danti Durga was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty. Danti Durga was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty. The Krishna first succeeded Danti Durga. After the death of Danti Durga, who take the position of the king? That is Krishna first. He also occupied Konkan, the area of that territory. Krishna first also defeated Vishnuvardhan of Vengi and the Ganga king of Mysore. Krishna first was fighted with the Vishnuvardhans of Vengi and Ganga king of Mysore, and he won that war. He was a great patron of art and literature. The Kailash temple at Ellora was built up by the Rashtrakut king Krishna first. The Kailash temple was built by in the presence of that Krishna first. The Rashtrakut dynasty was extended from the Vindh mountain up to Kanyakumari in the south. Rashtrakut dynasty, the ruler territories was extended from where? From the Vindh mountain up to Kanyakumari in the south.
This is a short important key notes for the Rashtrakut dynasty.
See, in this map, the orange shaded part shows the Rashtrakut empires. Here, everyone can see it. The Badami, the famous temples also is shown in this map.
It shows the the extent of the Rashtrakut empire. Now see our last video of Rashtrakut dynasty.
Rashtrakutas. Danti Durga was the founder of the Rashtrakuta empire from South Gujarat, Malwa and Bagelkhand in the north to Tanjore in the south. Was situated his empire. Krishna I, who was his son, succeeded him. He was a warrior as well as a supporter of art and architecture. His patronage is clearly proved by the rock cut temples of Ellora. Govinda II succeeded Krishna I. Govinda too was also called Prabhuta Varsa. Dhruva Nirupama, who was his younger brother, ultimately overthrew Govinda too. The prestige of the Rashtrakutas was immensely increased by Dhruva. The Vindhyas was crossed by him. He defeated the Pallava ruler Danti Varman, and his overlordship was accepted by the Pallavas as well as the Gangas. It is also believed that the Patliputras and were also defeated by him. The last great ruler of the Rashtrakutas was Krishna III. He succumbed to the attacks by the Chalukyas.
So students, in this video, we have seen that a brief history, short brief history of Rashtrakut dynasty. I hope all three dynasties are understood by each students. Now I'm going to ask you some recapitulation questions. First one, in which period Badami temple was built? Chalukya or Pallava?
Yes, tell me the answer. Which period Badami
temple? Chalukya dynasty.
Okay, very good. Badami temple was built up in Chalukya dynasty. Second one, which was the capital of Pallava dynasty? Yes, first option is Kanchipuram. Second one is the Kanyakumari. Which one is the correct? Capital of Pallava dynasty. Yes. Two options to you. Yes, the Pallava dynasty was
Kanchipuram.
Kanchipuram. The Kanchipuram was located in where? Tamil Nadu. The Kanchipuram is the correct answer, and Kanchipuram was the capital of Pallava dynasty. Third one, who was the first ruler of Chalukya dynasty? First ruler of Chalukya dynasty, Jayasimha or Pulakeshin? Yes, first ruler of Chalukya dynasty. First option is Jayasimha and the Pulakeshin. Second one is the Pulakeshin. Yes, tell me. Yes.
Jayasimha was the first ruler of Chalukya dynasty.
Very good. Jayasimha was the ruler of Chalukya dynasty. Very good, beta. The fourth one and the last one question. Who was the founder of Rashtrakut temple? Temple is given. Who was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty? Tell me. Here two options are given. Danti Durga and Harshvardhan. Second one, Harshvardhan. In our last dynasty, I told you that first point is about the founder of the Rashtrakut dynasty. Yes, tell me.
Harshvardhan.
Harshvardhan was the founder of Rashtrakut.
No, beta. Think again. Harshvardhan, the king.
Danti Durga. Danti Durga was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty.
Good. Dynasty. Very good. Danti Durga was the founder of Rashtrakut dynasty. Very nice, beta. King Harshvardhan's video we have seen. In which period? In the Chalukya dynasty. Okay. Now, see, this is our recapitulation question. And these five questions for the assignment.
Yes, student, here we end our lecture. Thank you.